Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Swan Lake is considered one of the classical ballet's biggest challenges for a ballerina. In one performance, she really dances two roles, the tender, lyrical Odette, the white swan of the second act, and the steely, scintillating Odile, the black swan of act three.
And the technical challenges of the white swan, variation alone. The control is so terribly demanding. This is virtuosity on a level of, it's like cream, it's like butter.
And so in one evening, you are soft and vulnerable. And then when you come into the ballroom as Odile, you are supposedly wickedly beautiful and seductive and completely dynamic.
Technically, now we're talking about the kind of virtuosity that is that what we understand that word to mean. It is fast and brilliant turns. It is high jumping.
Who can worry about Jillian's technique? She's such a strong dancer that it's a pleasure. I mean, sometimes I just find myself just completely with my mouth open because I'm in the back watching her turning or watching her jumping, and I just don't realize that I have to keep going and keep dancing.
We meet Odile at the ball Siegfried's mother has organized to introduce her son to his prospective brides. Four princesses from distant lands have come with their retinues, but ultimately the prince is captivated by Odile, von Rothbart's daughter, whom he has transformed to resemble Odette for the occasion. The climax of her dancing, both dramatically and technically, is the famous series of 32 fouettés, dazzling turns in which the dancer's leg whips around the body to propel the motion.
When I was little, actually, I made myself go in the studio and do one extra fouetté each day till it built up to 32. So I'm comfortable with the regular 32 fouettés. So I felt musically maybe I could add a little accent here and there. So that's why I added the few multiple turns, and I feel that is really a statement to Siegfried to just clinch the deal.
She gets him to say what she's been assigned to get him to say, and then it's over.
That's kind of strange, no? Why would he be attracted to this woman that apparently is so vicious and so horrifying, and so like, just you can see very clearly that she doesn't love him, she's just playing with him, but somehow he's drawn by it.
In swearing his love to Odile, Siegfried betrays Odette, condemning her to live as a swan forever. Only after he sees her in a vision does he realize his terrible mistake. He returns to the forest to seek her out and ask her forgiveness.
Certainly, Odette has gone through a huge journey. But I ultimately feel that the story happens to the prince.
His love is not as pure as he thinks it is.
When he is tricked by Odile, he doesn't yet understand, I don't think, the difference between the superficial and the real. And when Odette forgives him in the end, it then becomes very clear.
It's a story of humanity, of trying to control your mind and your heart at the same time.
Thank you.
Thank you.